Hola amigos, pero no, y saludos desde Medellín. Otro atardecer aquí muy bonito, ¿no? Como siempre. Mire, ninguna nube en el cielo. Muy bonito el día, ¿no? Entonces, el tema de hoy, ¿cómo utilizar como dice, nuestra situación única? En caso que nosotros somos normalmente el único, extranjero en cualquier situación que estamos hablando con nuestro nuevo amigo, nuestros nuevos amigos o nuevos compañeros en la nueva lengua, tenemos una posición única que nosotros pueda preguntar y pide por más información en cualquier punto de la conversación. Entonces, este es el tema de hoy y por qué puede ayudarte una frase en inglés que pueda ayudarnos. So, okay, here we are again, another lovely afternoon here in Medellín. So, as often at the weekends, I've just been catching up with my extended family here. And it got me to thinking that really, all of us, you and me both, because we're learning a new language and we're perhaps in a new country, very often we are the only person in the room who is not a native speaker. Now, this can be a disadvantage because everyone else can relax to their normal speed of speech, which can be a little bit quick, and we might be going, oh, I don't know, that's a bit fast. But the other thing to think about is that it gives us a bit of an advantage because people know that we don't necessarily understand everything that's going on in the conversation. So for us, it's quite easy, really, and we're forgiven if we interrupt the conversation every so often just to ask for a little bit more information, a bit of clarification as to what's going on, these kind of things. So it's quite all right if we say something like, I'm sorry, John, I know we're talking about this particular topic, but I got lost in the last part. Could you say that again, or could you explain that a bit more, please? Because this way, this gives you a chance to listen to it again, and no one really thinks you're being rude. They understand that you perhaps didn't quite catch all of that, and you're asking him really nicely, look, could you just, I got a bit lost there. Could you just explain what was going on? It's a quite a reasonable question. It helps you catch up in the conversation, and then hopefully you can then ask an interested question or make some other input because you're not completely lost as to what's been going on. So don't feel embarrassed that because perhaps the conversation has got a bit quick. It's like, oh, you know, I was doing okay then, and then someone changed the topic, or they were talking about someone else. I think I've lost what was going on, what happened. Don't be embarrassed just to ask the person speaking, sorry, I know we're talking about this topic, but I got lost on that last part. Could you just say that again, or could you just remind me what we're talking about? It's quite okay. You're going to be forgiven for that, and that will get you back in the conversation. So don't feel embarrassed about that. That's the point for today. When you're in these particularly group conversations, or if you really have, you're listening intently, you're following along, and then suddenly you realize that that last sentence, no, I didn't understand that. Don't be shy. Politely interrupt them. Say, look, I'm sorry, John. That last part you said, I'm a bit lost. Could you just remind me of that? Could you say that again? Could you just explain what you mean by that particular word, or could you just repeat that? Because I didn't quite understand that. It's okay, it won't knock them off balance too much. It keeps you in the conversation. And then hopefully you can ask, like I say, an intelligent question after that, or offer some nice input. So don't worry about that. That's the topic for today. Don't be frightened to ask for a repeat if you're in one of these conversations, because it is very easy to get lost. I just had to do the same thing just now. I was following the topic fine, and then suddenly, no, I've lost it now. I don't know what's happened. What happened there? There seemed to be a change in the story. I lost track of it. But I asked for a quick clarification, then I was back, and I could follow along. It was okay. So there we go. That's the idea for today. So from Medellin, before the storm over there, I think, might be coming our way. So we'll make a run for it now, I think. So I'll say cheerio. I'll see you tomorrow.